This little mammal is a scavenger. Called Didelphodon, she is a marsupial and specializes in raiding abandoned dinosaur nests. This evening, she could be in luck. Unfortunately, the smell of the nest blinds her senses to danger. It is the end of the Cretaceous period, and the continents are taking on their modern forms. But this ceaseless movement of the Earth's crust has also produced a surge in volcanic activity across the globe. Massive eruptions that have lasted for centuries have laid waste to landscapes and filled the atmosphere with poisonous gases and debris. This desolate world is still ruled by dinosaurs, as it has been for 160 million years, but they are nearing the end of their reign. Life on Earth is choking to death. Yet in the last 2 million years, the dinosaurs' most infamous predator has appeared. Tyrannosaurus, a 5-ton, 13-meter-long carnivore, specifically evolved to kill other giant dinosaurs. This is a male, and he's been drawn to the foot of this volcano by the smell of food. There are still islands of greenery between the barren lava flows. In the warm, moist climate of the late Cretaceous period, the vegetation has transformed. Instead of conifers, broad-leaved trees fill the forest canopy. Driving this quiet revolution among the plants is the remarkable evolution of flowers. Their secret lies in their intimate relationship with insects. This is now so close that some flowers can only be pollinated by insects, and some insects, like the butterfly, can only feed on flowers. And among these new plants, the birds are flourishing, and their calls now form an ever-present chorus. Millions of years of evolution have also created intimate relationships among different types of dinosaurs, especially the delicate balance between predator and prey. One dinosaur that specializes in defense is the extraordinary ankylosaurus. They are evolved to withstand attack even from giant predators like Tyrannosaurus. At 7 tons, ankylosaurus are so heavily armored that even their eyelids are hardened. And if that wasn't enough, they have a formidable club on the end of their tails. Sadly, not even these magnificent creatures have any defense against the natural forces that are suffocating their world. Herds of horned herbivores like these are very common and attract many predators. It is rutting season, and to display, the males flush blood into their crests, creating vivid patterns. These displays are designed to avoid physical contact. With 1 meter long horns, fighting can easily result in bad injuries. The best and the brightest display crest is usually all that is needed to settle arguments. Occasionally, showing off is not enough, and males resort to brute force. This was one fight too many. He will never again challenge for the right to mate. A male Tyrannosaurus has brought down a young Triceratops, but it is not just to satisfy his hunger. It is a gift. Female Tyrannosaurus are larger and more aggressive than the males, and he needs to court her with food to stop her attacking him on sight. The female arrives. She is wary. The male keeps his distance. Later that evening, they mate. This is the first of many couplings, as the male stays by the female while she is receptive, ready to see off any other males that might appear. Out on the lava flows, a group of Anata Titan wanders between islands of greenery. These animals are members of the hadrosaur family, the most common group of dinosaurs in the late Cretaceous. But their kind has evolved to thrive in lush lowland swamps, not in an ash wilderness. These little opportunists are about the only animals that are thriving. Soon the age of the mammals will dawn, and they will grow to massive sizes. But at 10 kilograms, this is about as big as Cretaceous mammals get. Months have passed, and the female Tyrannosaurus has built a new nest, camouflaged in the forest. Mother keeps watch. For the full 2 months of the egg's incubation, she will not leave her station or even eat. She knows her nest is a magnet to scavengers, like this dromaeosaur. The weeks pass, and above the brilliant volcanic sunsets, there are the telltale warning signs of an even more destructive natural disaster. Showers of shooting stars herald the approach of a giant comet on a collision course with the Earth. Far below, the dinosaurs are oblivious. Gliding in from the coast, a magnificent pterosaur, Quetzalcoatlus, is hunting for food. This is now a rare sight. For the last 20 million years, these flying reptiles have been in decline. Now these 13-meter giants are the only ones left. And this is a dangerous place to be. 1-ton crocodiles live in the lake, and one could easily drag the delicate glider to his death. Driven on to extinction. The skies of the future belong to the birds that already flourish around him. The mother Tyrannosaurus has broken her fast, and she is back with a vengeance. In the bushes nearby is the reason for her hunger. 3 Tyrannosaurus chicks wait, the only survivors from a clutch of 12. The moment they hear the kill, they start calling for food. Only 4 weeks old and less than a meter high, competition is intense between the chicks, and one is already picked on by the other two. They will remain under their mother's protection for at least the next 2 months. Soon after that, she will abandon them, or worse, view them as food. But their fate will now be settled, along with all the other giant dinosaurs of the Cretaceous. Three 3,000 kilometers to the south, the massive comet crashes into Earth. The light from the impact fades in silence. Then the shock waves arrive. Finally, a rain of molten rock starts to fall out of the darkening sky. This is the end of the age of the dinosaurs. The comet struck the Gulf of Mexico with the force of 10 billion Hiroshima bombs. In the catastrophic climate changes that followed, 65% of life died out. It took millions of years for Earth to recover, and when it did, the giant dinosaurs were gone, never to return. In their place have emerged other powerful and beautiful creatures. And we now know that one small group of dinosaurs did survive the extinction. And they are all around us today. The birds.